But as soon as you know he's done with you, he's going to do the obvious. He's going to troll you, and then he's going to try to cut you off from anyone that you might care about, your listenership. However, he can try, you know, to cut people away from you. And then he goes after anything you've ever told him. And if you've never told him anything, he will just make up lies about you. But he will make sure that you cannot comment. He will block you from commenting on his YouTube channels. He will block you to where you have no access to defend yourself. And that is a coward. That is no different than a cop beating a handcuffed man on the ground. He will not give you a chance to defend yourself whatsoever. He's a coward. That's correct. And that came right out of Deb's mouth herself. And she told me that in confidence when he was screwing around with that handler of his during the Marietta incident, all that stuff going on. And when she left him for, it was a little over a week. She believed he was an informant. Absolutely. And that he made that fax to throw people off so that they would, because they were going after him so hard that he created that fax to throw them off. That came right out of her mouth. So, yeah, I mean, how do you get a gun charge? You're pulled over in Cincinnati, Ohio. You have a gun with multiple, you know, you're in Ohio. If you have a gun, the clip has to be, yes, it's loaded. So the clip
one
has
in the
to
chamber.
Be, yes, the clip has, you cannot have a loaded gun. You can, and it has to be out in the open. He had it concealed. It has to be out in the open, and the clip has to be either in the glove box or in your trunk. It cannot be anywhere accessible for you to immediately be able to load that gun. Second of all, his tags come back a domestic terrorist. So, you know, Pete gets arrested and then gets out, blah, 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 does his stuff. And then a week before he's due in court on the charges, the sheriff drops the charges against Pete. But yet the Department of Homeland Security contacts me 2 days later after he left to go to Oregon. So that, to me, is just strange. Now, the only thing I can think of is maybe they dropped it because they wanted him to really hang himself out in Oregon. I'm not sure. But he's facing 88 years. He serves 2 years in prison. He's facing 88. I don't care what anyone says. He turned on some people to get out.
Let's not forget all the charges that dropped, Danny. All his charges
were dropped
in Oregon the day before his trial date. I mean, how many times does this stuff have to happen before people freaking get it?
And you know that when he went to Oregon and he went inside that refuge, he stole hard drives from computers. Government hard drives. The FBI knew this. How do you get charges like that dropped against you? And Deb hid the hard drives at one of the people's houses out there that were helping her. She hid the hard drives in the backpack for Pete. So how do you get off on charges like that?